here's some of the basic essentials for training on your dummy when you're trying to keep the mount. You don't want to lose the mount on your opponent. So, first one is going to be you want to practice with having your practice with your grapevines. Okay, grapevines are when you have his legs hooked here, right? The reason you're doing that is because if you don't, if his legs are like this, he's not on the floor. He bumps his hips up, he's going to throw you off, right? So you want to sprawl his legs out so he can't lift. And the way you do that is by hooking his legs here and sprawling them back. Okay, the dummy's not going to let you sprawl him too far. That's the first thing that you're going to do to maintain control on. All right, the next thing you want to do is he's going to be pushing you off with his arms, right? He's trying to push you out to the side. He's just trying to push you, get you off him. So one of the things you're going to do there is practice swimming inside. So you swim inside, right? Your goal is to be working your way down lower and lower to the ground. He's going to keep coming back trying to push. Each time he does, though, you want to keep working lower and lower until you finally get your way down. Don't put your hands close. He's going to wrap your arm and bridge you over, right? So you want to get your hands wide here, so now you've got good base. If he pushes you off, he manages to get his hands to your hips, push you to the outside. You just want to keep a wide base with you. Alright, if he keeps pushing, you just swing your way back to the center, swing your way back to the center. Keep this position. And the third thing here is, let's say you weren't able to swim down. He's got you here, he's starting to push you up, and you go, uh-oh, I might lose my position. But one thing you can do is, before you go off, you can hook his head, okay? Hook his head, that stops you from him from pushing off. So hook his head, he can only push so far. And he's basically just gonna use up his energy pushing against you. The problem is, this arm here, he's going to wrap it here and bridge his legs up over and take you out. So when you use this technique, when you hook his head, you wanna base yourself out to the side, okay? So if he's going to throw you over that way, you want to base out this way, right? Base out to the other side. Take your whole body off to that side so he can't bridge you that direction. Got too much weight anchoring you over here. And the next one is, one of his ways out is he's going to be using either his elbows or his hands to push your leg back so he can shrimp through and put you into the guard, right? So when he's doing that, This is very basic, but it's essential. When he pushes with either his hand or his elbow, pushing with his hand, scoop his wrist, bring your leg up. Don't grab his wrist, don't grab it like this. You want to scoop, slide your knee up, right? He's doing it with his elbow, scoop behind the elbow, lift it, slide your knee up. Another important concept here is really, even with your hands on the ground, how wide, you don't want to be holding your weight up, right? Let's say I weigh 190 pounds or something. Why would I want to hold 190 pounds myself where I can force him to hold 190 pounds? So you want to have your opponent supporting your weight as much as possible. So when you're down, say you slam your weight down here, he's pushing off, he's smashing you down, just barely fingertips touch. Now you've got all your weight on him. It's really impressive. It's very heavy on his chest. He can barely breathe. That's going to fatigue him a lot more. Make a whole lot harder for him to escape. Going back to your legs now with the grapevines, your opponent's goal is he's going to try to kick his legs out and get his leg out flat. In other words, you got his legs grapevine. When he's trying to get those out of there so he can get his legs to the center so he can bump up here. So he's going to be trying to kick it up and actually he's going to put it flat. He's not, most likely he's going to kick up, put it flat, so you can slide your knee out, put you in a guard in between his legs, right? So when he kicks his leg out, here's what you can do. You want to build this practice going back and forth between having the grapevines. Say he kicks the leg up, he's got his leg free. You put either the bottom of your feet together or cross your feet. When you do that, now he has no way to get his leg flat on the ground back here so he can put you in guard. So he's got nothing. He brings his leg back out, go back to grapevines, he kicks it out free, cross him, go back to grapevines. So practice keeping control like that every time he gets a leg free. And another thing you want to do regarding your grapevines and his legs is when you're back here, when you've got the grapevines, and your weight's out of your great, you've got good control, you're heavy on. Problem is, this street fight, you really, well, you can do some striking down here, but you can't do this kind of striking with your grapevines because your knees are back. I can't get up for it, okay? So maybe I can hit, do some hitting here. If I want to be bringing my weight down completely here, I've got to leave the grapevines. So you train going back and forth between the grapevines, up, high, high mount where your knees are up behind his armpits here, where you can strike, back to grapevines control. So he's bucking up, you know, he's trying to throw you off, you're able to hold on with the grapevines. He stops, come up to striking, he goes back to bucking up, come back. Okay, it's a drill for him. Now, when I talk about him trying to get his legs free, put you into guard, what he's going to be doing there is he gets his leg free, he's pushing on your knee again, he's trying to slide up and put you between his legs. When he's doing that, he's pushing you back, he's sliding up this way, right? So for him to do that, he has to slide up this way, right? He's trying to bring his knee through. For me to prevent him from doing that, particularly if I have a high mount, stepping back here, let's say he got his leg through, and I just cuff his arm, pull up here, pull my knees up, he's going to slide that way, right, to try to get back here again, where he can put his hand or his elbow to my leg. I can just stop him, keep my hand on top of his head. At this point, he can't slide forward, he's stuck there. And high mount, pretty high, he can buck his hips up all he wants to, but I'm not on him here, right? So he's not going to throw me off there. And we'll do one last thing here for helping maintain the mount, and that's when he's pushing you off. Well, let's say you are starting to lose your position, right? You messed up, he starts going, you feel like you're going to lose your position. So what you can do is you feel like, oh, I'm going to start losing my position, just pop up, come to knee on stomach, right? So your instep is tight to his body. This leg is out wide for base. A couple important things here. One thing you can do is put your hand to his throat here. Put a lot of weight on there, you can go for striking. But what this does, when you put your hand on his throat, it's a lot of pressure and it hurts, right? So instead of him pushing your leg and trying to push you off, he's naturally gonna go try to get that weight up, pressure off his throat. His hand's gonna come here trying to release it, which then positions his arm forward arm bar. Okay, so, or other techniques. And with his arms up there, you got a lot of techniques. So again, if he goes to push you off, you feel like you might lose it, we'll just put your hands either here or on the floor, pop up, and come out to the knee on the stomach.